I added a pressure gauge to my Moka Pot, and it's been a game changer. So today I'd like to share some of my experiences and what I've learned. In my opinion, one of the biggest challenges with the Moka Pot is over-extraction. The resulting brew can easily end up far too bitter, to the point where adding sugar or milk, and sometimes both, is almost a requirement. The Moka Pot brews with pressure, much lower than your typical espresso machine, but it's still pressure. And the issue is that you mostly don't know how much is being applied during the process, and how that's affecting the flow rate, and ultimately, the resulting cup. You're basically flying blind. When you start your brew, you have no way of knowing what's going on inside. The only real feedback you get is the coffee coming out. At that point, it's kind of too late. This is in contrast to something like the flare, where you get immediate feedback and have full control over the pressure being applied. You can pause the brew at any time, for example, to pre-infuse, and can ramp up or down the pressure throughout the shot. The Moka Pot doesn't have this level of control, but with a pressure gauge, I'm at least able to get more insight into what's happening during the brew. People say that the Moka Pot delivers between 1 to 2 bars of pressure, but you're not immediately hitting the puck with that. It gradually ramps up as steam builds in the boiler. And I think what you want is to control that process. This is especially important near the end of the brew. Typically, this is when the pressure will be at its highest. At the same time, being mostly extracted, the puck will offer less resistance, and so the flow rate will increase. I think between the two, this is where the over-extraction is happening. With the flare, we typically ramp down the pressure at this point to keep the flow consistent. That's really hard to do with the Moka Pot, especially with the lack of feedback. Most people will just say to halt the brew as it gurgles by running it over water or immediately pouring it out. And another method I've come across is to remove it from the heat well before that point and just let the residual pressure complete the brew. For me, this has generally worked pretty well. But now with the pressure gauge, I have even more control and have further improved my results with that method. I'm able to somewhat regulate the pressure, keeping the maximum between 10 to 15 PSI, or around 3/4 to 1 bar of pressure. I found this to be the sweet spot for me. And since I'm holding the pressure constant, it then becomes easier to control the flow rate toward the end of the brew by just letting it ramp down from that point. Overall, this has helped me better understand the brewing process and filled in some of the gaps I've had in understanding the results. I'm getting some pretty amazing cups, to the point that the Moka Pot is now in heavy rotation. In conclusion, I think this mod has a lot of potential. It shows that there's a lot more that can be explored when it comes to stovetop devices. You kind of see this already with the 9 Barista, and I'm hoping there's more innovation like this in the future for stovetop brewing. Anyways, that's all I have for today. Thanks for watching.